What's going on, guys? I thought I'd do a quick review of this Jackery Explorer 5000 plus generator. We had a couple nasty hurricanes last year down here in Georgia and did not want to end up losing power. So I thought I'd give this thing a try as a backup plan to power most of the things in our house. So this massive portable power station, it's perfect for keeping your home running during outages or even for like an RV adventure. I'll cover how to integrate this directly into your home's electrical system using a 50 amp inlet to your breaker box, and I'll give my thoughts on the Solar Saga 500 panels that pair with it perfectly should you want to charge this for an extended period of time. So if you're tired of blackouts and want reliable solar charging, you want to stick around and check this out. First off, for the unboxing, the Jackery Explorer 5000 Plus comes in a sturdy box, and inside you've got the main unit and also the AC charging cable with the user manual. It's got a sleek and compact design, though it weighs about 61.5 pounds, but that makes up for it with its wheels and telescoping handles, so you pretty much can roll it around like a suitcase at an airport pretty much. So it's surprisingly portable compared to other heavy duty stations, and don't get me wrong, it's not for backpacking, but you can roll it around in your garage or even at the campsite for your RV. So let's talk some specs. This will provide 5040 watt hours with a lithium iron phosphate or life PO4 battery. It's expandable up to a whopping 60 kilowatt hours with the add-on battery packs, so that's a ton of power for your house to last well beyond a week, it seems like. Output wise, it's got 7200 watts continuous power with dual voltage support, which is huge in my opinion. So this can support 120 and 240 volt simultaneously, which is pretty much anything running your fridge, your lights, heavy duty power tools, even your electric dryer. It has multiple AC outlets, including USB ports, a 12 volt car output, and even the RV friendly connections. So the LCD screen is bright, it's intuitive, showing you the real time battery level, the in and output watts. Charging, you can pretty much juice it up via the wall outlet, your car, or even solar, which I'll talk about later, with a max solar input if you have other panels of up to 4,300 watts for ultra fast charging. Now, one of the coolest features, in my opinion, and which is why I bought it, is for the home backup. It's how you can plug it directly into your house. So this Explorer 5000 Plus integrates with your home's electrical system through a 50 amp generator inlet connected to your breaker box. So basically, you install a generator inlet box outside your home, or in this case, it's inside my garage because this gives off no CO2 emissions and it's super quiet. I hired a professional electrician to wire it to my main panel with this interlock kit for safety, and then you're going to want to connect the power station using a compatible 50 amp cable as you see here. This lets you backfeed power to selected circuits during an outage. Think like your fridge, your lights, maybe your sub pump. It's not fully automatic with the whole home system like some pricier setups, but for the cost, it's an eco-friendly way to avoid some gas generators. Just remember to follow local codes, and again, your professional electrician will know what to do. And also, I did mention I did purchase a Jackery Solar Saga 500 panel that's rated for 500 watts with an impressive 25% conversion efficiency. So they are also bifacial, meaning they can generate power from both sides if you position them just right in the sun. They're also IP68 waterproof, making them durable for the outdoor use. Connecting them to the Explorer 5000 is plug and play. Just use one of the included cables and you can chain multiple panels for faster charging. In full sun, one is rated to pull between 450 and 480 watts. However, when I was bringing it outside and testing it, it pulled in maybe 380, 390 watts. Overall, lightweight for their power. They're around 30 to 40 pounds each. They're quick to deploy and they come right out of the carrying case and go right back in the case for easy storage. You can also use other solar panels from third parties using the high PV input or the MC4 input. These solar panels will plug into the low PV input, which is the 80-20 port on the side of the Jackery. I do plan on getting another one of these because they do recommend using two Solar Saga 500X panels. So for example, if you're recharging from 20% to get to 100%, it will take about 6 to 8 hours to charge in good sunlight. Overall though, the pro is this is expandable. Like I mentioned earlier, you can add more batteries should this not be enough for your home. And also, Jackery's app is very intuitive. It shows you where all the power is going and how long it will last, and you can even set times on when you want to charge this during off-peak hours. And also, it works really well if you have a home integration with Jackery's smart transfer switch. you can see I had my electrician install this interlock switch. Here's the main 200 amp service breaker to the entire house. And then we have our 50 amp breaker for the generator. And you can see how the switch will not let you turn this on until you turn off the power to the main part of the house. This way we're not sending power back into the grid. So you'll need this installed by a professional electrician if you're not comfortable doing this. And you can see I have these all highlighted with green dots, so I know which ones to turn on, which will then turn tell my generator to provide power to each individual breaker. There are certain ones that don't have green dots on. For example, I'm not going to power my 100 watt tankless water heater because it simply cannot handle that. There's other ones like the electric fireplace I don't need, my Tesla charging ports I don't need, and also there's the AC unit and furnace that would push over 100 amps that probably would not be able to handle it. I did not test that yet. But the rest of them, like my stovetop, oven, cooktop, you can see it, they should be able to handle this no problem at all. However, if I'm running this all at once, obviously it's going to cause the Jackery to flip or turn off. So you have to be conscious of which outlets you want to run all at once. But in hindsight, you can come back to the garage and turn off individual breakers you do not want to power. Should you want to provide more power to, for example, your oven or stovetop, if you're powering all four stoves and burners and the oven and microwave at the same time, you may want to turn off other breakers so you can provide more power to these outlets. So I found this would be the cheapest method to have him install this 50 amp inlet outlet versus having the Jackery switch box. All right, so we're gonna simulate a power outage here. I'm going to turn off this main 200 amp breaker box, and then the lights you'll see in the garage will turn off. There we go, and now I'm able to flip up this interlock kit and turn on the generator. Before I do that, I want to make sure all these are in the off position so we don't overload the Jackery at once. So I'm going to turn all these off. And now that all my breakers are off, I'm going to go ahead and plug in my Jackery here to the side outlet, the 1450. And you can see we're already plugged into the inlet. We also have to turn on this AC switch, and that will enable all these outlets and also the side outlets. So now these are all in the off position. I can now flip up this switch here and turn on the generator, 50 amp. So now that that's on, I can go ahead and slowly flip on the ones I've highlighted in green, just one at a time so we don't overload the Jackery here. And there we go. As you can see, I turned on the house and now we're pulling in about 800 watts directly to the home. And you can see, depending on what's being used, clearly the fridge is powered on right now. I'm sure some ceiling fans are on. We'll last here about a little bit, 4.8 hours. And that's where the solar panels come into play. So I'm also gonna plug this into the Tesla and see how much input we get through this way. I also forgot I have these garage LED lights. I'm gonna turn these off because you can see it's pulling quite a bit of juice. I'm gonna see what happens when I turn these off. Wow, okay. So clearly I'm not gonna have the garage lights on. Now we're only at 400 watts for the house and we're over 9 hours plus before we deplete this battery. And I got this charging cable for the car and an extension cable. And I'll have links for these in the description should you want this, but I'm gonna plug this in to the Jackery and see what we get. Looks like we're pulling in 92 watts from the Tesla port in the center console. And then you can do the, on your Tesla screen, the keep accessory power on so that we can close the doors and your Jackery will keep charging even when your Tesla is in a sleep mode. It'll just keep the 12 volt socket powered on. Alright guys, so I literally have my oven preheating, I have the air fryer going, I have the stove top running, our TV, internet's all running, and there's a few various lights on including our bathroom, and we're still pulling a 4,000. This can handle up a peak of 7, but clearly this thing can handle pretty much the basic needs of what we need to deal with during a hurricane, or if we have no power for a few days. You can see we're only gonna last an hour powering all this at once, but clearly it's not gonna be on that long. Well, it looks like we're even jumping now. Maybe the oven's kicking even further. It's still kicking just fine. 5,000 watts, 5,600 watts. And you can barely hear the unit. The fans are really quiet. You don't need to put this outside. There's no gas fumes. All right, I'm gonna turn off the units in the house. All right. And we're back down to normal TV and internet with a couple of ceiling fans and the lights. All right, so now that we ran a few tests, I'm gonna first turn off the Jackery. We're gonna go back to the grid. I'm gonna unplug this. Alright, and before we go back to the grid, I'm just going to turn these all back off again. And now you can see we have to turn off the generator block before we can go back to grid. Let's turn this to off, and now this enables us to turn the grid back on. And now we can turn these all back on. And now the generator obviously stays off because we cannot do that with this interlock kit.
So if you're in the market for a reliable, expandable power station that bridges portable and home backup all in one, the Jackery Explorer 5000 Plus with the panels might be a solid pick. It certainly could power your home as a backup for a couple days, and even further if you add more batteries to it. But overall, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. I'll be sure to answer any questions you have if you leave something in the comments. Until the next video, stay safe and I'll catch you in the next one.